in the world. All fears are gone. And I know that my Savior lives. And he holds the future. I don't know if he holds the future in his hands. Because he lives, I can celebrate Juneteenth. So he makes up our Juneteenth. He said, that's a Juneteenth to all people. Amen. I believe that we can celebrate Independence Day. We can celebrate Juneteenth. Amen. We can say, happy Juneteenth to all of our people. Amen. Amen. Thank God for history. And the Bible says, declares to us that individuals who perish, they perish for lack of knowledge. And then he goes further to say, because they rejected knowledge. And that's why we're in the predicament that we're in today, right now, 2020. But I don't know about you, but it may look a little dismal to some, it may look a little gloomy to some, but it's actually hoping what's going on. Anybody with me? Anybody can see your future? Can you see a better future as a result of what's going on today? I heard the Holy Spirit this morning while I was in prayer, and the Holy Spirit said this to me. He said that there was a better chaos on the earth in the beginning, and God saw an opportunity. Hallelujah. And God saw an opportunity in chaos, and then he said, let there be. And that's what he's doing right now. In the midst of all that's going on in America, God is saying, let there be. Hallelujah. What God declares, that's what's going to happen. I wish I had more witnesses out here. And I love when God speaks, things happen. And I think that's the neglect. The neglect of many is that we're doing everything but going to God in prayer. That's what he said. That was in the song, wasn't it? That was in the song. We're going to everybody but God in prayer. I believe if we go to God like he said for us to be in 2 Chronicles 7:14, I believe we'll feel different in our land. And guess what? Through all of this, what we see right now, I guarantee you that you're going to see clarity after a while. Amen, somebody. Amen. We love the Lord today. And thank God for us. Thank God for the band. Amen. Thank God for the band. Thank God for my wife. Thank God for my friend, my family. Amen. Thank God for the Buchanan family being with us today. Amen. They came in, and I thought we was about to get mad when they walked in here with all those masks on. Amen. That kind of scared me. Amen. But we thank God for COVID-19. Amen. That we honor COVID-19 we have here. Amen. We respect COVID. I told my wife when it began, I said, I will not be eating out anymore. Amen. I won't be going to nobody's restaurant. I'm talking about I want to go order. If I can get a to-go order, I can go in and get it. I just don't have people left out here. The same people who prepared my food, amen, to-go would be preparing my food if I went in the restaurant. So I declare I won't be eating out. Amen. Because of all that was going on, his father, they said, well, we're gonna have a blackout. No, I had a blackout long before he was eating. I could see that he from anybody's plate, amen. Amen. I could see my wife cooking ice cream, and I know she's fine, amen. So I think we all use wisdom during this time. I know they told us we got go roaming and going places, but I think we ought to still be wise in where we go. Amen. If they're not family, I'm sorry. They're just going to have to miss me because I'm not coming around. There's no somebody. We just got to use some wisdom. That's why the Bible says, he that wins souls is wise. So if you can win souls being wise, you can save your souls being wise too. Amen. Using some wisdom. But I just want you to know today that we're glad to be here in the Island Church. We're glad to come back to this, revisit this message. The Lord, he had me on dealing with praise food. I think we need to gradually, we need to come up in our praise. Because the Lord said something, and I'm mindful of it, is that if we want to invite his presence in our environment, if we want to invite his presence in our atmosphere, then it's up to us to create that atmosphere that God is welcoming. And one of the things that does that is praise. Praise
praise invites the presence of God wherever you are. I mean, sometimes we'll take for granted and we'll say, you know, I know God is here because he said, well, there's two or three gathered together in his name, he's in the midst, but you got to be in his name. You got to be gathered together in his name. You just can't assume that God's going to show up because two people are in the same room together and they say, we're believers, so God is Lord. That don't necessarily mean that. Because if you came together in his name, you come to make some changes. I wish I had somebody. I make some changes in some situations in your life or some situations and circumstances in the lives of others, then you can invite the presence of God in where the ear of God can lean toward you. God loves that. David, the psalmist that wrote this. David wrote in Psalm 22 and 3, he said that God inhabits the praises of his people. Now, and I'm a firm believer, if God moves off my praise, how long would God live if he had to depend on your praise? Glory to God. That's why my wife and I didn't communicate what the lesson was going to be today. We didn't even talk about it. And she came up here and she read for your listening, Acts chapter 3, when the two men of God went to the temple to pray, they ran into a man who was at the gate that called Beautiful, and he was crippled. Oh, God. He was crippled all his life, and then he was begging on. He was asking after something, and I got something out of this. He was asking them for money. He was asking them for a handout. And they said, put in gold now by none, but first I got half. I give that be in the name of Jesus Christ. And then he leaped that. Watch this. He leaped that, ran in the temple, ran in the house of God. And the Bible says he leaped and he rejoiced and he began to do what? Praise God. Ooh, see, when you do something outwardly, people see you praising God, you telling your testimony. Glory to God. When people see you praising God, you telling them that I honor God. You telling them that God did something for me. That God did something in my life. See, a miracle was performed in this man's temple, and he was in the temple. He didn't shout out to God, heal me. I just said, help me with this. He didn't shout out to my miracle outside. He didn't say nothing. All he did was begin to praise God. And as he was looking God at all the people, began to look at him, and they said, that must be the man who was standing outside, who was crippled on the outside. God, I remember him. That's what people do when you start praising God. When you start looking God up in your life, they say, I remember him. I remember he used to be a beggar. He used to be a whoremonger. He used to, y'all in talking to me today. He used to be a drunkard. He used to be a dope dealer. He used to, but now because I see him praising God, I look at you, look different on him. But it was well. Somebody said, but it was well. My Bible tells me, y'all don't mind me preaching, do you? My Bible tells me in 1 Timothy chapter 15, David was bringing the ark back to Israel. And as he was bringing the ark, the presence of God back, he was inviting the presence of God back to the house of God. He was inviting the presence of God back where it belongs. Somebody said, where it belongs. How do you know that the house of God, that's where the presence of God belongs? It belongs in the house. Somebody touch your Bible, says, the house. It belongs in the house. So if the presence of God belongs in your house, I want to know, do the other P's belong in your house too? The other P's praise. Somebody said, praise. Praise is what I do. Praise is who I am. See, some people, they got to have somebody to backdrop playing a certain tune for them to praise God. They got to have somebody beat on the drum for them to praise God. But let me tell you something. The Bible says, let everything that has breath praise you alone. Glory to God. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, you ought to be praising God. I know. On this day, this historic day on yesterday, we still celebrate the day called Juneteenth. Let me tell you something. There is something else that people did besides making do with the food that they had, the scraps that they had. They were putting meals together. There was something else they did too. They made music with pots and pans. They music with spoons.
Glory to God.
They made music with the rock bowls. The same thing they washed the clothes with the dirt on the clothes with education. They also used the same rock bowls to praise God. And Paul said, "What they did too? The same thing they hung the clothes on, Paul, the clothes hanger. They used that as an instrument to rock that rock bowl." And we call the old soldiers. I wish I had somebody. We call that old time religion. But let me tell you something. You were praising God, but God wasn't sure. They praised God with their hands. That's what the Lord said. He said, praise him with the hand clap. He said, praise him with the lack of sounding symbols. He said, what happened to him that had a breath? Praise the Lord. And that's what I love about David. David was a young man when he began to praise God. He didn't wait till he got older to praise God. He praised God in his youth. The Bible says that David prayed. He prayed so in his young age. That even the sheep obeyed him, but the sheep recognized his voice at first. You know, it's not about music. We said we heard. They said music calms the average beast. Music will change your mood. And they said music makes your body move. I wish I had you some help on here. See, you need to learn to praise God for what you get. So we'll wait till we get some abundance, and then we'll praise God. We'll wait till we get that house we're praying for, and then we'll praise God. We'll wait until things change, until we praise God. But you ought to praise your way through. You ought to praise until something happens. You ought to praise God until that thing you're praying for materializes. Because somebody said, I got a testimony. I got a testimony. And what I learned about testimony is that testimony says you passed your test. The testimony is a declaration that I passed my test. My testimony is a declaration that I don't do what I used to do. I don't do all my social media those tests. I don't go to places I used to go. Even more, that's my testimony. I passed my test. Somebody said, I passed my test. And not the king that was before David by the name of Saul. He didn't pass his test. God told him. He said, I want you to kill the king David. Not only do I want you to kill him, I want you to destroy everything you've got. I don't want you to take nothing. Bring none of that junk back to my house. In the name of God, the prophet Samuel. When he went to Saul, he said, Saul, did you do everything the Lord told you to do? The king has no reason to lie to this man because he's the king. He could have told God and do what he said. But no, he's got the mouth. And he said, yeah, see, I got you. Everything he told us. And he said, well, what is that out here beeping in the background? See, your testimony would be, you're doing what God told you to do. Somebody wave your hand. There would be no breaking in the background. I wish I had you some help out here. See, people recognize when you did everything God told you to do because they don't see when their own stuff hanging on you. The Bible says that there will never be in Christ. He's a new creation. He's a new people, a new species. Everything that passed away, the whole all things become new. Somebody says, new is new is new. I used to get mad when I see certain things happening. I used to cuss people out. When they said certain things to me, I used to be bothered by certain things, but they don't move me like they used to because I'm a new creation. Even God is on the inside of you. He'll make a difference inside of you. He'll ask about the limits of difference. Yeah. If he's inside of you, he'll talk to you. Somebody said, he walks with me. And he talks to me. See, when he talks to you, things around you will change because when you change, things around you change. We always have people who, when they get hurt, they want to change the other person. They will tell them, "Hey, you ought to not talk like that. You ought to not wear that. Or you not ought to not do that like that." But if I change, it's automatic. I want to stop things around me because we can last. We want to accept us teaching. He showed us how mighty he was. He showed us how powerful he was. A mindset of the same man by the name of Isaiah. We don't talk about him a little bit. Isaiah. And Isaiah chapter 6, the Bible says, it was during the year 10 of God died. Now see, things equal. Things when somebody close to you dies. Now the person who depended on Isaiah depended on King Ozai. They were pretty close, and King Ozai died, and he couldn't find his normal companion. He couldn't find a king that he could communicate with anymore. And all of a sudden, through the things around you change, you change your perspective. And he looked up to God in the house. And when he looked up, God said, "It's time for me to reveal myself to him." God showed him himself. He showed him what goes on in heaven. He looked up and he saw the angels of God. See, one day, we're going to be like the angels. But let me tell you something, you better practice being like them now. Because when Isaiah looked up, he saw the angels saying, "Holy! Holy! Holy! Holy Lord God Almighty! Holy!" See, they saw God for who he was. And let me tell you something, when you see God for who he is, you're praising. Yeah, you'd be like Abraham. Abraham had a spontaneous praise. He had a sporadic praise. He had an involuntary praise. When you think about what God has done in your life, and you think about the changes that God has already made in your life, I wish I had to somebody. See, one thing I understand is being saved 40 years, I'm not where I want to be, but I'm not where I used to be either. I wish I had you some help around here. See, what you got to appreciate, you got to celebrate where you are now. You got to celebrate your progress. You got to praise God for where you are now. You got to praise God because there's some stuff falling off me. Yeah. And I find myself in situations that I would have probably been in those same situations some years ago. I wouldn't have passed that test because I wouldn't have been trying to pass that test. I wish I had somebody. But I'm so glad that now today I'm trying to pass the test. I'm doing my best to please God. So when you live to please God, you don't allow anything to impress itself to you. But it's Job said, he excused evil. He hated evil. Mm-hmm. And we want to know. Can I read something to you? I'm going to get back to this. Why don't I read something in Psalm 15. Psalm 15, y'all come on. This is not the message, but we are invited to the ministry of praise today. Psalm 15. Now listen to this. I want to see your hands. If everybody going to heaven, let me see your hands. If you're not going to heaven, you know you're going to heaven. Let me see your hands. You pay one hand, Jason. Okay. Because if you confused me, then I have to be patient. I want to know who's going to heaven in here. Glory to God. So when you start praising God, I want to see who knew what they're doing. You know? Who praises him because they got a relationship with him, not because I feel praise him. Because it's easy to do what somebody tells you to do. All you got to do is be a coach. That's why people get coaches, because they don't know what to do on their own, so they got to have somebody tell them what to do. It's automatic. I don't need no coach. The coach inside of me called the Holy Ghost. And he will teach you, the Bible says, he will teach you all things. I said, all things. There's an area in your life you want to get better in? It's the Holy Spirit. Y'all see this outfit I got on? The Holy Spirit dressed me. He dresses me all. I'm telling the truth. He dresses me all. I just put stuff on. I wait until the Holy Spirit put it in my mind. He arranged it in such a way that I said, "Did that go again right there?" See, when you got the confidence, you know he told you to do it. But that ain't true that they're doing like that. I wish I had some help. See, I know how to put some stuff together because I was a professional model. But when the Holy Ghost had me put something together, I said, oh, we got some help. Well,
I want you to feel bad about the person I was
have bad news? Who's going to heaven? Somebody say, who's going to heaven? Let me see the hands. I ain't lost nobody yet. Ain't that? You look around here. You see him going to heaven. Watch this, y'all. In whose eyes a vile person is condemned. We can call bad news. That which is filthy must be filthy still. That which is vile must be vile still. Amen, somebody. Same thing. Y'all know how we used to make people think we were part of what they were doing because we were partaking with them so they don't feel bad. I'm sorry, I ain't partaking with you so you don't feel bad. Because if I partake with you, I'm going to feel bad. Somebody give me a witness. I ain't going to partake with you. But see, Peter proved to the people he wasn't with Jesus, he was called cussing. I said, the way Peter proved he was with Jesus, he started questioning. That's how people know you're not with the Lord when you start questioning. I wish I had some help out here. When you start using that foul language, that profanity, right? See, one thing I used to, when I was growing up, my mama used to be the witness to what I'm saying to you. And they used to tell us in my own house, I better not ever put no cigarette in your mouth. If I do, I'll make you eat it. But they used to ask me to go and light the cigarette format on the stove. I know, that's an awesome moron, isn't it? How you gonna tell me not to smoke and you're giving me the cigarette and telling me to go light it for you? You ain't gonna light my cigarette. Because if we want a band for the band to remind us what Jesus won't do, then we'll be more mirrors of what we do. And I say my people. Because I'm supposed to be like him. That's it. We did ministry. We ministry of praise. That's what we mean. Because everything we do, that's it. Everything we do should predicate Jesus getting the praise from what we do, from our actions. That's it. Because he tells us, he says, and I believe it's in Matthew 6:14, he says, let your light, and you know, we ain't got no light, man. These lights shining on me, that's not me shining, that's the light shining. But watch this, the same thing with Jesus. He said, let your light so shine. Let my reflection come from you. Let the light of me permeate from your life. He says, let your light so shine before men that they might see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. I'm about to close this thing up. So, I still see those angels there. I still see those angels that Isaiah saw. Because what he saw had an impact on his life. See, what we see in the church should have an impact on our life. And I'm so glad y'all showed up today because the Holy Spirit gave me something. The last time I preached, he told me, he said, the devil is trying to murder the church. Preach, I know this thing. God had nothing to do with this pandemic. Nothing. Absolutely, positively, nothing to do with this pandemic. So let me tell you something. Because if he did, that means the whole world would be laid out and the church would be raptured up. I got my people. So God had nothing to do with this pandemic. Watch this, watch this. But he allowed it to happen to get a reaction from everybody, the whole world, the whole world, the whole world, the whole world. But the one who should be reacting different is the church. And I'm not preaching. I'm not preaching. Watch this. Here's my preaching. That's CJ. CJ is the baby in the family. Am I right? CJ is Tyler and Deuce's son. Am I right? So therefore, they expect, when they see DJ, they expect the teaching that goes on in the Buchanan house to project from his life. Am I right? So the same thing with God. God expects to see. Oh, y'all better come and go with me. We call him Father, don't we? We call him Daddy, don't we? Yeah, we should get an attribute and the characteristics and the personality of our Father. That's what Isaiah saw. Isaiah saw that angels doing what God wanted them to do, and they were a reflection of who God is. They were saying, what did they say? Holy. They were reflecting to who God was. And they said, holy. And what they were saying and what God there saw, it had an impact on him. And impacted him so until he wanted to get his life right. Beautiful, you said, Isaiah chapter 6. He realized that he had been walking in. He realized he had been associated with the wrong people. See, that's what I learned when I got saved. When I got saved, I stopped dealing drugs. Then somebody had to knock on my door and tell me, say, you know what, you gotta stop doing the drugs that you did. Then he said, didn't I do that? Nobody had to tell me. Then I had to stop chasing that dollar bill. Nobody had to tell me that. When I gave my life to the Lord, it was automatic, automatic. And one man said, looking for me, they said, I'm done. Because, see, the best way to help you not to do something is put to the Lord again. If anything, I'm telling you, I was just 22 years old, and this is what happened. Anything I couldn't see the Lord do, I knew I shouldn't be doing. For example, I didn't need nobody to send me more itinerary. Listen, don't do this, don't do that. Do that. That's religion. That's what religion is. Religion says, you know, you can't come to church with my shit, rock on. That's what religion is. Religion says, you can't come to church with short stone preachers. You can't be a good preacher with no short things on. Yeah. Or in your church, you ain't preaching in your church. That's what I said. Let me say that again. I said, you get mad at me if I came in here with short hands on, you're not even in your church with a suit on. And you judging me. You should be judging yourself and ask yourself, why am I not in the house of God preaching the word of God to the people of God? It don't matter how you do it, we need to be in the house of God. See, some of us, we put in this pandemic for convenience. Let me say that one more time. I said, we're taking this pandemic for a convenience. You don't want to go to church always. You don't want to be on the praise team always. You don't want to pastor always. I wish I had some money back. You don't want to pastor always. Yeah, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to tell you what I hear on the whole. I hear the Holy Ghost telling me to pray on y'all. You love the Lord. Your love is in your action. Love not in words, but in deed and in truth. And what you do, that's what love is. Love is what I see right now. My family over here to my left, he says, hey, they ain't got to come to church. They could have went somewhere where isolated, where there's the water. I wish I had this on the head. They could have got a water hose like we did when we were children, and we had a good time with our water hose. was there happy somebody? We had a pool. Yes, we did. We had a pool. Jeff was a free pool. But let me tell you something. Mama said, y'all can't go to the pool. He said, well, Mama said, we put the water on. Said, we can run out there and stop. We had a good time spraying that water. And see, while we're spraying the water, you didn't see the rainbow. You didn't see the rainbow. We had a good time. You got the water to create your own farm. You got the Bible says, but he that honors him, that fear the Lord. Anybody honor those that fear the Lord? Those who get good justice and reverence him. He that swears to his own birth and changes not. What ain't going to heaven, y'all? He said, you ain't changing. A change is not a change until it changes. You won't be looking at him funny when you see him because you get a gift. That's what I do. When I give somebody something, it's a gift. They say loan, but I'm giving it to him because I won't be looking at him when I see him. I won't be looking at him like an old man. Yeah, y'all know what I'm talking about. Yeah, y'all know when people are old, you want your money. He will put his money to you for you. Just trying to praise God, y'all. Your take of reward against the innocent. Nor take of the Lord against the innocent. He that doeth these things shall never be moved. He that doeth these things shall never be moved. He that doeth these things shall never be moved. See, that's what we want to do today. We want to go to ministry, the ministry of praise, and David, what better teaching that we can have than a man by the name of David? Isaiah 43:21. We all familiar with this chapter when it talks about when you walk through the flood. But he made me for himself. God did not make me for my pleasure. He made me for his pleasure. The scripture says, and that's what it says, that these people have a form for my steps. they shall show forth my praise. They shall show forth my praise. God gives praise from your actions. God gives praise from what you do. That's it. But he also gets praise out of what you don't do. If I was on my job and somebody passed me a duty, if I was on my job and somebody passed me some loud, y'all know what I'm talking about now, and I say, no, I don't do that. And they say, well, you don't do that. Because I'm saying, see, people want to know why you don't do what you do. And you want to be a testimony. Somebody say testimony. You want to share with them that because the Lord is in my life, because the Lord has come and made a change. Somebody say change. A change in my life. I got to read the whole. Because let me tell you something. I heard that. Look at this. Psalm 149. Y'all listen to me. Come on, go with me. The ministry of praise. Come on, say ministry of praise. The ministry of praise. Nobody, I don't think we can get a better teacher than David. David is the best teacher when it comes down to praising God. You can't go wrong when you go to David, ministry of praise. See, if I told you to come to ministry, or ministry of praise, then you might not get a good lesson. You might not get the best instructions, but when you go to David's school of praise, let's hear what David got to say. David said, praise ye the Lord. And he said, and there's a period. Somebody said, praise ye the Lord. Okay, now I'm going to read it, and I want y'all to respond, okay? I want you to respond when I read it. Praise ye the Lord. I got two. Praise ye the Lord. I got four. Praise ye the Lord. Wait, what was that going to do? The drum, so you can hear a drum, you can speak for that. Praise ye the Lord. I wish I had me somebody. See, that's what he said. That's what he said. David said, do what? Praise ye the Lord. See, if I told you to praise me, I would expect you to put your hand on it. So I would do nothing for you to praise me. But if God has done anything in your life, you should have a reason to praise him. Somebody said, you should have a reason to praise him. Let me tell you something. I heard somebody say it was my former bishop, the late Bishop Lawrence Sanders here. He said, if you think, you're safe. I said, if you think, you're safe. Somebody said, I was close to death, but then God raised me up. Anybody ever say, Lord, if you get me out of this? Yeah, Lord, somebody said, Lord, if you get me out of this. I said that so many times. I said, I'm here. That's why I'm praising. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, my soul cries out. Hallelujah! I said, God, for saving me. I said, when I think of his goodness, that's why when I read the book, that says, praise the Lord. I don't need no platform. I don't need no YouTube. I don't need nobody to push me to praise him. Because when I think of his goodness, that thing in the depths of the book and to bring you in and to pour us over. Y'all ain't hearing me, please. We must remember, Father, sometimes when I should have been in the prayer, I wasn't in the prayer. But when it wasn't one time for me to go, I was. I wish I had knew somebody. That's why I didn't have no problem serving 26 months. For something I didn't do, because I got away with a whole lot of stuff that I did do. But I thank God that they didn't trust me then, because I would have been gone for a long time. I said I would have been gone. They would have had me for a life sentence. Y'all ain't hearing me. But I thank God for stepping in. Thank God for the time when I should have been dead. Y'all ain't hearing me. I think about the time when I stole some I should have been stolen. When I took some I should have been taken. That don't go into this body. You promises, you know what I'm talking about. You'll be taking stuff and we ain't even sick. I wish I had you with me. You'll be taking stuff. And we're not even sick. All you doing is creating a problem. I wish I had you with me. I said, all you doing is creating a problem. When you're taking any medicine in your body, when your body ain't treating nothing, I wish I had you with me. You got these people who smell this thing, marijuana, and they say, you know, it's good for cataracts. You ain't got no cataracts. They smoke the marijuana, they're good for your eyesight. They ain't no wrong with their eyesight. It's been good for you. When you got some problems, you ain't got no problems. I wish I had you with me. It's been good for your eyesight. It's good for people who can't be still. It brings them under control. But you ain't got that problem. Why you smoking it, then? If it slows people down, it's going to stop you. As you shall have, you need somebody. I feel like preaching today, y'all. I ain't got nobody want to preach with today. Thank you, Father. Thank you, amen. I got no deacon over there. Don't thank you, Father. Amen. I ain't got no help in other places. I'm trying to get me some help down here, and I can't get no help. I got people doing their own thing, Father. Why are you paying this church? Do you come to church to praise God? Or are you paying to do your own thing? Do you come to church to get the Lord out? Or do you come to get your own thing? Do you come to praise Him? Or do you come to get some praise? I wish I had you come down. This is not the first church of the Lucifer. This is not the I am church of prayer church. It's not that I am church of bad people. We are alive according to the scripture. Peter said we're alive this day. Do we have any alive souls in the house? Do we have anybody who walks of God in the house? Do we have anybody who can clap your hands and give God the glory? Do we have anybody who can shout and give God the glory? Do we have anybody in the house who talks to the common word? Do we have anybody in the house who can raise your hands? You say, I'm not walking over the path. I may not be able to say that, but I can stop my feet. You got to reign. You can praise them. Somebody say praise them. I'm going to praise them in the morning. I'm going to praise them in the morning. I'm going to praise them in the morning. Midnight hour. I've got to praise them. That's what David says in the ministry of praise. David said, praise them on the field. Praise him. Praise him and find a loud sounding finger. Again, just in case. You come right off in the roof. You say, I'm going to go to the hospital. For your edification. The Holy Spirit wants to build you up. Can I make it? The Holy Spirit wants to say something to you today that will impact your life forever. Somebody show up here and say, I will not be the same that I was when I walked through those doors. My life will be the same no longer. There is a change that has taken in my life because I heard the word, this is a change agent. The word of God will change my life forever. Listen to these verses and you go. Psalms 150. Starts out just like Psalms 149. And it says, and God excuse me for being redundant, praise ye the Lord. Pardon me for being redundant. It says, praise ye the Lord. That's what it says. Praise ye the Lord. That's what it says, Charlie. It says, praise ye the Lord. That's all you got it. It says, praise ye the Lord. There's something about it. See, praise is an atmosphere thing. When you praise God, it changes the atmosphere. That's it. It don't just change where you are. It changes everything around you. From the north, the south, the east, and the west. Anything that has to do with you, when you praise God, it affects all of them. See, that's why, and it's another key in Paul's prayer. That's why it says in Romans chapter 8, 26, 27, it says, we don't know how to pray as we ought to pray, but the Spirit makes an intercession on our behalf. This audience is this audience. That in other words, the Holy Spirit will pray prayers for you that you don't even understand this way. He'll pray prayers for you that you'll be wondering, I don't have a room on the plane for that. He'll pray for you. Somebody say, he'll pray for you. Just like he'll pray for you in the same thing, the praise the same thing. Watch it. Praise you the Lord. If they praise the where? Ooh. Is that what your Bible said that? Praise the where? in the sanctuary. Can I say something? Can I say that? You know when the people of God, the God brought them from Egypt, brought them from Egypt, right? And they were drinking the water, and they were getting sick. And the Lord told Moses, he said, put this in the water. Put this stick in the water. And he said, but I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. So if God healed them then, why are we scared? Why are we scared of something that God is giving? Why am I afraid of the sickness and God is against it? Why am I afraid of a pandemic and God is against the pandemic? So if God is for me, why can't I put this on this? Nobody says anything nice to them. If there's God before us, who? Read Romans chapter 8 for your learning, but read the whole thing when it talks about family and pestilence. It says, what or who shall separate us from the love of God, which is what? In Christ Jesus. It says, shall a famine do it? No. Shall pestilence do it? No. I wish I had you some help like this. You know, you know your Bible, you ain't said a nothing that the devil is in your life. But you know God got you. Somebody said, God got me. Now, this is for those who don't quite, they don't learn stuff as quick as fast learning, so I'm going to speak to you. But be wise, though. Don't be going to a circle of things about your mask and words on. And say this, somebody. No, don't be going to these places taking it for granted that a person that has the virus didn't touch that thing, you touch it. And make sure when you get ready, before you get in your car, you take them off and throw them in the trash. Don't get in the car thinking you're all right. You got the gloves on, you don't touch anything, and you don't get it. You might as well not wear a glove. I've been looking at people, I said, man, would you take those gloves off? I do. Make all my shadows in. I said, would you take them off? Why would you tell me to take them off? Because I sanitize everything around here, you can never see it infected. Because I saw you go out this house with your girlfriend, and you touch the door with your girlfriend. You sat up there next to us with your girlfriend. Like you just had so, I don't want what you got to be passed on in my spirit, so I'm going to ask you to take them off the door in the car. And thank you for wearing your mask, because your mask is helping me. I do tell them that. I'm going to wear one so I can help you. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you. Watch this. I'm going to read my verses on my website. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him in the firmament of his power. God created the atmosphere. God created the firmament. And he wants us to praise him in his power. Somebody say, in his power. The reason why many of us don't come to church to praise God is because we're doing our own thing. You say, I'm counting power. I'm so tired. I can't clap my hands today because I'm so tired. I can't pray today because I'm so tired. You can't stay at home and look at me. I mean, it's an easy solution to that, isn't it? I mean, why go to church tired and you can stay at home and look at me? It's never true. The people come to church and complain. Don't you? They'll complain about being tired. Why are you going to church? You need to stay home. And if you say because you won't pass me to your cash app, I'm going to cash app all your good things because I still need that money. I ain't going to get it. I don't want to get it. I'm just real. I'm real. I am. And then say, you don't teach people they want money. And I'm a teacher. And I'm a leader. I lead. And I'm short. That's my assignment. That's what God told me to do. He said, I call pastors after my own heart who will instruct my people and give them understanding. Knowledge, can I say knowledge? And understanding. And understand is to stand under the authority of God. What is it saying to you? It says, praise him for his mighty acts, for the things that he's done. Praise him according to his heavenly greatness. Praise Him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise Him with the suffering heart. That was David's thing. Praise Him with the tumble of the band. Praise Him with the string instruments and organs. Praise Him upon the loud sounding cymbal. Praise Him upon the high sounding cymbal. Let everything that has breath praise Him, the Lord. Come on, say, praise the Lord. That's it. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I made it, and that's it. There ain't no reason for you to come God, I don't know what will be.
If you have never knowingly or willingly asked Jesus Christ to come into your heart, to come into your life as your Lord and Savior, this is the day you can do it. The scripture says, declare unto us in Acts chapter 4 and 12, that there is no other name whereby men must be saved but by the name of Jesus Christ. I know, there are many names out there. There's many names that's out there in the world today that they're telling you, oh yeah, that's the way right there. You should be a Moor. You should be a Muslim. You should be a Christian. You should be a Christian. You should be a Jehovah's Witness. You should be a Baptist. You should be a Pentecostal. You should be a charismatic. But if there's none of that, it's in the name of Jesus Christ that you should be saved. No religion, no denomination, but by the name of Jesus Christ. I remember preaching in a Muslim mosque, and when I preached there, the Holy Spirit called me. He said, tell them this, that I said in Matthew, listen to this, in Matthew chapter 6 and 5, and Jesus said, he said, I am the way. He said, I am the way. The only way to God is Jesus Christ. I know all that other stuff sounds good, it's good education, but Jesus said, I am
the way. And if he's the way, that's it. There is no way. He didn't say this. He didn't say, I am another way. He said, I am the way. He said, I am the truth. And I am the life. Not a life, another way of living. He said, none of that. He said, I am. So if you want to get to the Father, you have to come to Jesus. He said, I'm the door. He said, I'm the good shepherd. Hallelujah. He's the only way to the Father, y'all. There is no other way. I'm sorry. Maybe you've been taught wrong for all these years, and somebody told you it was this and it was that, but I come to tell you that Jesus is it. And there is no other way. And right now, if you want to receive Jesus as Lord and Savior, all you got to do is say, Lord, come into my heart. I believe that you are the Son of God, and you died for my sins and the sins of the world. Right now, I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. If you did that, you're saved right now. If you did that, I want you to type it on your screen. I want you to post it on your Facebook page and your Instagram page. I want you to tweet it. I want you to tell you to tweet it. You know what I'm saying? You ought to tweet it. I'm saved. Amen. You ought to tweet it. Say, I'm saved. I received Jesus Christ in my life on June the 20th, one day after Juneteenth. I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I receive my freedom, my real freedom. I receive it. And I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I didn't get free because of some emancipation proclamation. I didn't get free because of some Juneteenth. I got free because of Jesus Christ. Amen, somebody. He is the Son made free. Yes, free indeed. It is good to have the Lord on our side. Amen. Thank you all for coming. Thank you all. Thank you all. Tyler and the girl. Amen. We're going to have a good time today. I hope y'all say amen. We're going to have a good time today. Amen. I think we just had a good time and we can talk this if you don't try to do it. Amen. Again, thank you, Facebook, for doing this. Instagram, Twitter, all of you guys. YouTube, follow us. Follow the island folks. I want you to get on your timeline. I want you to have a watch party. I want this to go viral. I want to go all over the world. Because the world needs to know that Jesus is the only way. The world needs to know why we praise him. You need to see me and see why I praise him. I praise him because I got a reason to praise him. Because the Lord has been good to this man right here. Can I say amen? So right there, right where you are, I want you to tell everybody, stand on your feet, stand on your feet, everybody. It's time to go home. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord God, thank God for my lovely bride. Thank you, baby, for coming on your left. Amen. Thank you for making it. Holy time to me. And I thank you for it. Amen. For this time of year. And be guided through your name. Come on, lift up your hand. I want to give it to you. Let me see your hand. Let me see your hand. See that hand. That hand is close to your heart. And I want you to hear that to make what I say unto one. I say unto all.
What?
And pray. And love the Lord with all your heart,
with all your mind,
with all your soul, and all your strength. And love your neighbor as yourself.
Let's
look at the end of that
neighbor.
Neighbor,
before you leave,
you know your elbow.
You know
her, baby. You know her elbow. You know her elbow. You know her elbow. God bless you all. Thank you for doing this.